Hi guys, in this video I'm going to teach you three important topics for beginners in AutoCAD. How to insert dimension lines in order to appear always with the same size in the paper, doesn't matter the scale we use. How to fill closed boundaries with a common hatch and some tips to use it. Finally, I will show you how to calculate areas. Okay, let's learn how the annotative dimensions work. So, first of all, I will click in the tab Annotate, and in the dimension section, I click in this little arrow here to open the dimension style manager. Here, I will click on the annotative style, and I will click in Modify to edit it. Now we are in the section text, and we can see here the text height, which is set up as 3 mm. As this is a good size for viewing in the paper, I will not change it. Then I go to symbols and arrows, and also the arrow size has 3, which is good for me. So I can click in OK. Now close. OK, now I can start. But before, I will show you a new tip, which is available since AutoCAD 2016. So, I'm going to type DIMLAYER, press Enter, and I have to insert the name for a new layer which I want the dimension lines in, for example dimensions. And by doing this, every time I create a new dimension line, it goes automatically to that layer. So, let's start drawing annotative dimensions. First, I want to draw these two dimensions here, and this viewport is in a scale of 1 per 100. So, the first thing I have to do is to change the scale in this icon and select 1 per 100. Now I can type DIMLAYER or click in the icon over there, press Enter. And I'm going to draw the dimension line here. I click in the first point and now in the second point. But as you see, the text here is very small. And it happened because I forgot to change the current dimension style. So, going back, I can change the style here and select annotative. Now, it should be fine. So I click in the first point, now in the second point, and I place it here. For the next, I press Enter to reactivate the previous command. Now I click in this point, and now the second, and here it is. So if we go now to the layout, you can see that the arrows and the text are visible, and when I print, the text and the arrow's height will be exactly 3 mm, as it is what I specified before. Now, let's draw the lines which are in the viewport with scale 1 per 30. So, what do you think I should do? It's simple. Do the same process. I have to change the scale to 130. Now I will draw again the dimension line here, and then I will draw these other two here. When I zoom out to see all the drawing, you can notice that the dimensions I just made are much smaller than the other ones. But in fact, if I go to the layout, you can see that they have the same size in both viewports. I also need to tell you another thing. You cannot see the dimensions here, because as I drew them in a scale of 1 per 30, they will only appear in the viewport that has the same scale, which is this one in the right. Now, the last thing I want to talk about in this video it's very important, are these icons here about annotation objects. The first one here that says show annotation objects, if it's switched on, all my annotation lines are displayed in the drawing. Now I'm going to deactivate it and look what happened. The dimension lines I have there disappeared, and the only ones that you can see were made with the scale that appears here, which is 130. So if I change to 100, you will see only the other ones. In this section, I'm going to explain you how to use the command hatch. This command is using for filling enclosed areas as a solid fill or with a pattern or gradient fill. To use this command, we can click in the icon here. We select an enclosed area and click. So, as you see, I fill this enclosed area with the color defined in my current layer, which is white. For the shape, we can use one of the patterns located in this panel there. The first one that says solid fills the enclosed area with only one color, and the others have the pattern indicated in the image. Now I'm going to choose this one, but as you can see, it looks like nothing happened because I can see only one color there. This is because the scale of the pattern is too small, with the spacement as only 1 mm, as you can see in this section. Now I am going to change it to, for example, 10, and you can see the difference there. Then we can press Enter or S or Escape to leave the comment. As you can see, the hatch I just created, I can click there and select it, as it is considered an independent object, like a line or a polyline. Okay, now that you know the basic to use the command hatch, I must say something. It's recommended to create a separate layer for the hatch command. It's important because if we are working in a project with lots of hatch objects, the computer may get a bit slow, especially when we are using patterns. So if it happens, just freeze the hatch layer and then the work speed should be fine. Okay, I'm going to insert a layer for the hatch, but I will use a special command for that, which is available after AutoCAD 2016. I will type HP layer and press Enter. Now, I type the name for the special layer for the hatch command, for example, just hatch. Then, if I activate the hatch command, I can see the new layer appearing in the list. So, from now, each time I use the command hatch, the objects go automatically to that layer. Now, imagine that I want to fill several areas, but I want them to act as a single object. Simple. I click in one area, then I click in another one just right away, and I keep clicking in the areas that I want to fill. Now an important thing. It's better to do this process with a solid pattern, because if I use one of the others, they are a bit heavier and the computer may get a bit slow. Also, sometimes, especially for large and more complicated areas, the fill may take few seconds to appear. Also, if you make a mistake in the filling, you can go back by pressing Ctrl Z and then you can continue. When I finish, I press Enter or Escape. And if I want a specific pattern, it's better to specify it in the end. If I want to change the color, I go to the layer hatch and I'm going to switch it, for example, to green. Before finishing this tutorial, pay attention to this example. Imagine I want to apply hatch to this area. It could be to indicate a different apartment, for example. What I need to do is to create here a rectangle and then apply hatch there. This is the process. First, I create a new layer for the rectangle. I name it as border. I am going to change the color. For example, I choose this pink one. Click on OK. Now I activate the layer. And I'm going to draw a rectangle. Over there, I click in this point. This is not with precision, so the second point can be there. Now, if I want to apply hatch to the rectangle, I should turn off all the layers except the layer border. So I'm going to click with the right button here, and now I'm going to choose select all but current. It selected all the layers except the active one. Then I click in one of the lights there to switch off all the layers except border. Now I can activate again the command hatch by typing H, and I'm going to click inside the rectangle. Oh, it didn't appear. Yes, it happened because I also switched off the layer hatch. So I switch on this layer. And I can also switch on all the other ones. I click with the right button. And now select all. And click in one of the lights. The next step. I have to select the hatch of the rectangle. I click with the right button. Go to draw order. And click in send to back. Now I'm able to see all the other objects. But if I select again the hatch and go there where it says hatch transparency, it's set as 0. So I'm going to click in this bar and drag it to the right. For example, here. And if I press escape, I can see it more transparent. In the last part of this video, I will explain you how to calculate areas in AutoCAD.
It's very simple and I will show you two ways. The first way is what I use most of the time. We can type with the keyboard area or AA, or you can click in the icon under measure and click in area. Now I will calculate the area for this room. And what I need to do is to click in all the corners to cover all the area. I will start in this one. It's important to click when it's highlighted in the screen the endpoints, in case that you have the object snap turned on. And when I finish, just type enter, and the calculated area will appear in this box. In my case, I have the units on millimeters, and that's the reason why I have this long number here, that in square meters would be only 14. Now, the second way I will show you here is to calculate the area of a polyline or a region. For cases like this, if I do the process before, it would take a long time. So, I will click in the command again, but this time I will type object or O. I type enter, now I select a polyline, and it calculated the area automatically. This is very useful for site plans, maps, irregular shapes, and all the cases that takes time to draw all the boundary. So that's all for now.
Thank you very much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to CAD in Black to get access to the full list of tutorials of AutoCAD. And if you need extra help, I start providing online private lessons for beginners. Just send an email to cadinblack@gmail.com and I will provide you all the details. Thank you again and see you next time!